Ever wondered how you can spawn items, deploy units, generate obstacles in Unity? This can be done using a simple function called Instantiate. In this video, we'll learn how to spawn a game object or a prefab into your game scene at any point using Unity's Instantiate function. Stick around till the end of this video for a performance enhancing Unity Instantiate trick. The Instantiate function takes in four arguments. First argument is the game object or the prefab. Second is the position at which it needs to be spawned. Third is the rotation of the spawned game object. And fourth is the parent of the spawned game object. Now, out of these four arguments, only the game object parameter is mandatory. Here are four distinct ways to utilize the Unity Instantiate function. First is just saying Instantiate game object. This will spawn the object at the position and rotation of the game object to which the script is attached. Next, you can say Instantiate GameObject and provide the parent. This will spawn the object as the child of the parent GameObject. Next, you can say Instantiate GameObject position and rotation. This will spawn the object at the specified position with the given rotation applied to it. Next, you can give all the four parameters like the GameObject position, rotation and parent. This will spawn the object at the specified position with the given rotation applied and will also assign it as the child of the parent game object. The object passed to Instantiate function can be a game object or a prefab. A game object is any object that is present in the scene's hierarchy list. Keep in mind, if the game object is inactive in the scene, then the spawned object will also be inactive. A prefab is a pre-configured game object that is kept inside the assets folder ready to be deployed. To create a prefab, assign all components and scripts to a game object and then drag and drop it to the project window. Now you can delete the object from the scene hierarchy and just drop the prefab into the scene when required. Now let's try to instantiate a sphere prefab into our scene when the game starts. Create a new empty game object in the hierarchy window and name it Spawn Manager. Let's add a new script with the same name to the game object. Now open the script for editing. Declare a serialized field variable of type GameObject so we can assign it from the inspector window in Unity. In our start function, let's instantiate the GameObject. We'll not provide the position, rotation or the parent as of now. Now let's go back to Unity and assign the sphere prefab to our script. Let's play the game. And the sphere is spawned at the same position as the spawn manager. Let's take a look at a different example. Here we'll spawn the sphere when the left mouse button is clicked. Let's go back to the script and change the start function to update. Let's check if the mouse button is pressed using an if statement. If input.get mouse button down 0, then instantiate the sphere. Now let's go back to Unity and test our script. Play the game and click on the screen to spawn the sphere. For the next example, let's try to instantiate the sphere as a child of the spawn manager game object. Let's update the code to take in a transform parent. And change the instantiate function to instantiate prefab and also pass in the parent. Now let's save the script and play the game. Now we can see in the hierarchy that the spawn sphere is a child of spawn manager. By default, any game object that is instantiated in Unity is given the name of the prefab followed by clone in brackets. The name doesn't make any difference unless you want to access it using the name. Now let's update the code with a local game object variable and assign the instantiated object to it. Then let's assign a new name to this game object. In this case, we can call it sphere. Now let's go back to Unity and play the game. So as you can see now, the name of the game object is set to sphere. Now let's modify the code to instantiate the sphere at 10 in the x-axis with the rotation set to 0 in all axes. To do this, add a new vector 3, 10, 0, 0 as position and quaternion.identity as rotation to the instantiate function. Quaternion.identity will reset the rotation of the prefab to 0, 0, 0. Keep in mind that you cannot specify position in instantiate without providing the rotation or vice versa. These two parameters will need to go together. Now let's check if the code works. Let's set the rotation of the sphere to 90 in the y-axis and play the game. The sphere is spawned at 10, 0, 0 with a rotation of 0 in all axes. To spawn the game object at its own rotation, just provide the transform rotation of the prefab for the transform parameter inside the instantiate function. That covers all the basics of Unity Instantiate. Now it's time for the instantiate secret tip. In case you want to spawn a projectile like a bullet in your game, normally you would assign the instantiated game object to another variable and then use getComponent function to get the rigid body component. Then we'll assign the force value to it. GetComponent is very performance expensive, especially when done for a large number of objects. To simplify this, you can pass a rigid body directly to the instantiate function and Unity will instantiate the game object as a bonus. That way, you don't have to use GetComponent function. Now here's how to do it in code. So rather than taking in a game object, let's take in a rigid body. And let's pass the rigid body to the instantiate in place of the prefab. Then we can directly assign the instantiated object to a rigid body and add force to it. Now let's play the game and see what happens. So as soon as the sphere is instantiated, a force is added to it and the sphere starts moving in the right direction. That's it for this video. Hope it was informative. Subscribe to our channel for more Unity tutorials. Thank you.